Hello everybody, Crusade here, just with a bunch of guys here, and we are killing dragons the way it was meant to be. We have the ladderer person, you know, walking back and forth, making the dragon walk back and forth there. And then a bunch of us are all sitting right here, and we're all just shooting. So here he comes, our ladderer person is Vortex Mobs. What a brave soul, and I'm here with Gauze and Ice for Life, and a bunch of other guys. I'll know who they are later. But I'm in here, I'm like the noob of this team. I'm like level 18, everybody else is like 20s and 30s and 40s. Somebody's hitting 70. If you see the 15s, that's probably me. Yeah. This is just, it's like rare to see this and endless these days. I remember back when there was like one person soloing the dragons all the time, they're like auto-speeding. Like just before the old endless server crashed and or was taken down. Yeah, we're doing pretty good. I'm probably never ever going to get drops because I can't kill him. I'm doing enough damage. Yes, I do too, Gauze. I do too. I also want to turn on. But you know what I want more is a double costume. Are you recording? Yes, I am.
Nice!
Yeah, Ice for Life. Nice. It is nice. I just woke up kind of recently, so I'm all like stuffy sounding, but wish there was more stuff to talk about, but this is just us killing dragons. I always wonder what those earthquakes are for. In various places, they're just earthquakes. You know, the Death Cave, the Dizzy Desert, and the this place. I don't know what what do they mean? What do the earthquakes mean? I don't get it. Never understood what they meant. Maybe it's just for show. Fluon Sword. Never liked the way those dragons look. They look like Barneys. I don't know, they're just odd looking. Their head's kind of weird, and they have like a huge brainy head, and tiny little wings, and these little feet that just walk around. Their tail's small, and I don't know, they just look odd. I wish they were more like, you know, crawling dragons, but this is only supposed to take up one tile, so I don't really get sick of them done there. Wah, wah, oh well. The game is still has pretty decent graphics for what it is, I say. And the drop is usually it's just nothing or it's gold. Occasionally we get a wing or a claw, sometimes we get a Draco. Let's hope it's a Saw or a Scav Bow or something. Gold. Oh well. Here comes the next dragon. How are these guys all like in their level 30s and 40s? I don't understand how anybody can get to that level anymore. Unless you just auto 24/7, but come on. Come on. And it's a nothing. Womp womp. Oh well. How about how for some reason in Endless the typing is really weird. When I try to type fast like I normally do, everything just gets, like, stuck. I don't understand why. Like, it doesn't let me... If I try to type a sentence, some of the letters just don't appear. Because it doesn't let you press a certain amount of keys at the same time, I guess, and then just blocks it, and yeah, that's what happens. Uh-oh. Eh. See, you would've been dead if I didn't. Thank you. No problem. What are you doing, man? He's killing himself. Because when you sit down, the monsters never ever miss you. That's the thing, so Okay, I think we're back. CO. What does that stand for? Corrupted thugs. No, I'm not much of a corrupted thug. I'm more of a guardian angel. And the drop is more gold. And these dragons only give like 380 experience or whatever it is now. That's like nothing. They used to give like 1,200. Why is that, Voltar, huh? Why did you decrease the experience? And the biters only give you 41 experience instead of 81. Somebody please explain that to me. I don't know why the game... He just made all the monsters give you less experience, and I don't understand. And here's another thing I want to rant about. You know all those autoers? But they say, like, I'm using this bot on Global, and they're, like, announcing it. What is the point of that? Yeah, they're advertising it, but it makes me put them on my ignore list because I think they're spamming stuff, which they are spamming stuff. But then later, they stop using the bot, and then they're out in, like, Avon, they're talking, or they're buying and selling or whatever, and then they're on my ignore list the whole time. Like, I'm probably trying to sell something, and they're PMing me, but I don't know it because they're on my ignore list because their stupid bot has to announce stupid crap that nobody cares about. That just sucks. It's always something I wanted to say for a while, because that's happened. Like, I'm having such a hard time selling something, and then later I realize it's because somebody was trying to buy it, but he was on my ignore list the entire time, and I just didn't know. Because they're bot. Like, why do the bots do that? If you're going to make a botting program, why make it talk? Everybody's going to want to ignore you. They think it's cool or something. Like, I'm out in the sheep and I say something to somebody else, I'm giving them some armor or something, and they're like, message detected, you said this, and they just spit out the same thing you said. What's the point of that? Do you think that's, like, technical? No, you suck if you make something like that. You're stupid. Everybody's just gonna hate you for it, idiot. Why do that in a script? See, items that you craft stuff with usually keep a steady price for the most part because you constantly need those items. When there's inflation, like too much of one item, obviously the price, you know, goes down because nobody needs them as much because they're everywhere. When you craft stuff though, when you craft an item, the items, the ingredients used to craft something, they disappear. They go into the void. They're gone for good. They're not in a locker or anything. They're not in the game anymore. They are deleted. So the price goes back up again after you craft something, and it's really slight, so usually the price stays pretty constant. The only time prices for ingredients go down is when you've crafted too much of the item, and then not as many people need that item anymore, and then people continue to get ingredients for it, and they're piling up, and they're either not crafting it, or they're crafting it into items nobody needs anymore, and then that's when the prices go down for ingredients. That's how it works, but for the most part, they stay pretty constant. Like, ice cubes stayed at a good 1k to 500 gold for a while, for like a long time, because they were constantly using them for frost arrows, and you used like 42 of them, so they'd stay at a constant price. But the problem is, since this is such a small community, then, you know, after you make too many frost arrows, everybody has them, nobody really needs them anymore, and then they start piling up all over the place, and then the price goes down, and ice cubes become virtually worthless after a while, especially because all the botters are harvesting all the ice cubes, and they're just like generating them basically. Come on, I gotta get this kill. I feel it. Oh, nothing. Dang it. Oh well. I'm just ranting a bunch. Alright, guys. See ya. What's your name? Vortex Bomb. Vortex Mobs. It's been real. It's been real what? Oh, people are constantly disappearing. They're scrolls. Alright, well, that's the end of the video, I guess. Just killed a couple dragons, and, yeah, that's it. So, I will talk to you soon. EOBroadcast.weebly.com. I am Crewside. Check it out. Oh, and A Black and Gauze, I'll say bye too. Say bye, people. I'm gonna stop recording. Bye, YouTube. What about you, A Black? You gonna? He's laughing. You gonna? Oh my God, is that cool kid? Yes, he is a cool kid. What about A Black? You gonna say something? Okay, bye.